By a show of hands, how many of you have gone to a doctor and you've had less than a satisfactory experience? By a show of hands. Huge, huge. So let me tell you about a story. A couple of months ago, I had an eye infection. And if you don't know what an eye infection is, you're probably better off. I looked like a zombie with red, puffy eyes for weeks and weeks and weeks on end. So as any normal person would, I went to the doctor. After 40 minutes of waiting, I was seen for 2 minutes. The doctor opened the door, stood in the door, and wrote a prescription in under 1 minute. The next minute, I was outside the office with a prescription in my hand and still unsure of what I should be doing. I had to take a course of antibiotic drugs and stay there for 2 weeks. Later that night, being a mommy's boy, I ended up chatting with my mom, and after I consoled her about I was okay and I was gonna be fine, she mentioned something crazy, and it's this. She ended with this line. It's that in my time, drugs were the last option. And that got me thinking. The way we do healthcare and the way our healthcare system has evolved, we live in a reactive model of care where we go to the doctor only when things go wrong, and has become this ordeal of patchwork. Every time that our body breaks, we patch it up by drugs, or we patch it up by going as far as surgeries. Instead of going into healthcare, we're doing what I like to call sick care. And the missing link is clinicians, our patients, and our providers not having enough data. So how do we get this missing link? The answer is twofold. Number one is the organization of data. The second is the data collection itself. When we go out to the doctor, not only should they have our file records and have all this information, almost always they're just left there with one file with maybe our name, our health card number, and what we did in the last visit. And that's extremely, extremely scary that we're letting doctors make decisions based on pattern matching. And as an example of myself, that visit did turn out great, and it worked out great for me. A couple of weeks later, my eye infection was cured. But there should be two ways of looking at data that I'm about to propose today. The first is the genetic approach. So that's studying our systems from the inside in. We have DNA that converts to what we like to call RNA, that converts to proteins, and that makes up who we are as human beings. That's what I like to call the inside-out method, studying our systems from the inside in. And then the second part is our biochemical approach, what we study from the outside. Our bodies are great at excreting, you know, tears, urine, blood, and all these analytes that we can analyze for biomarkers. I see a future where these two will converge, and these will be the best ways to map out a complete health profile. And that's where data collection will come in. The second part, data organization, is where we need collaboration. More than any time, we need it now. Our clinicians, our patients, our insurance providers all need to work in an ecosystem, not just in silos with misincentivized structures, so that all this health information can be translated from one unit to the other. I want to end off with this thought here today. In the last year, we spent $4 trillion on our healthcare, and that was just in North America. Take that in for 1 minute, $4 trillion on just healthcare. And that's growing year over year at 7%. This is a battle against time, ladies and gentlemen. We have a limited time before our funds run out, and we'll have to revert back and decrease the amount of healthcare that we provide to our patients and to ourselves. What scares me is that we're not doing enough, and that's what I want to encourage today. I want to see a future where instead of Harry waiting for 40 minutes to get 2 minutes of a doctor's time, he should have known about what conditions he was going to have beforehand and how we could potentially prevent them from happening. I should have known about my infection weeks and weeks before it actually took place. I want to see a healthcare system where we don't work in silos. I want to see a future where we can do information tracking and manage the flow of diseases so we don't get an Ebola crisis again. I want to see a future where drugs are the last resort. Thank you.